Lentiviral vectors offer stable integration of your gene of interest into a host genome, allowing for greater reproducibility when you are repeating experiments involving transgenes, a transfection. Lentiviruses can transduce both dividing and non-dividing cells. So how do you get your gene of interest with viral sequences flanking it into a cell so that you can produce virions for transfecting your target genes? The lentivirus vector is constructed as follows. The gene to be transferred is flanked by viral sequences that can be recognized by viral proteins in a packaging cell line to package the viral genome into viral particles. Cell lines that express viral proteins, such as the HEK293T, which stands for human embryonic kidney cells, are the most common cell lines used for packaging. Other packaging cell lines that can be used include Chinese hamster ovaries or CHO cells and NIH3T3 allow you to create virions capable of transducing a target cell line. So the initial transduction results in a polyclonal cell population where the integration varies from cell to cell. That is, the integration event, this is because the integration event is random. You also see different numbers of integration events from one cell to the next, particularly if the multiplicity of infection is greater than one. To select for cells with similar integration sites and number of integration events, you can select monoclonal colonies for expansion. So transfection is the delivery of exogenous nucleic acid to cells. And with this technique, you are balancing effective delivery of your nucleic acid with the health of the cell following the delivery. Reagents are used for this because the cell surface is negatively charged and the nucleic acids you wish to introduce are also negatively charged. So there is inherent repulsion between the two. Consequently, you use reagents to neutralize the charges, and it also helps to form a complex with the DNA and condense the DNA so that the cells are take it up much more readily. The classic reagent that was used was introduced back in 1973 by Graham and Wiggler, and it's calcium phosphate transfection. It's very cheap reagent and it's available in most labs. There are other reagents that are available commercially. They are cationic lipids, and these interact with the negatively charged DNA that you wish to introduce, or nucleic acid you wish to introduce, and give it a positive charge, and also encapsulate the DNA into a liposome so that it can be taken up by the cells via endocytosis. There are also cationic polymers such as polyethylene imine, PEI. There's some basic proteins or peptides, dendrimers, DEAE, dextrin, which are all cationic polymers that do the same job and allow you to change the nucleic acid to positively charged and condense it as well so that the cell will take it up. You can also use physical means via instruments to aid in the transfection. Some of the physical means include electroporation, microinjections, wireless delivery, the gene gun, or magnetic transfection. But the method that we're looking at uses calcium chloride mixed with HEPs buffered saline, which is called the calcium phosphate transfection. Here's what you do. You first mix your DNA with calcium chloride. Then you add the calcium chloride DNA mixture dropwise to the HEPs buffered saline. You need to introduce bubbles while mixing the two components. You can do this by vortexing the HEPs buffered saline while adding the DNA calcium chloride mixture dropwise. The point of aerating the system as you add the two components together is to ensure that you form fine precipitates of DNA calcium chloride rather than clumps, which would be hard to enter the cells. So which cells to use? We've already mentioned that HEK293T cells are your most common cells that are used. The T means that this cell line, which is the parental cell line, is HEK293. The T means that it expresses the large T or tumor antigen, which is important for replicating plasmids containing an SV40 origin of replication. So when you get your plasmids, lentiviral plasmids, they will have an SV40 origin of replication. And to have these replicated in a cell to high copy number, you want to use a cell line that expresses the SV40 origin of replication. And HEK293Ts do just that. In the producer cells, the viral proteins expressed by these packaging constructs bind the sequences on the DNA plasmid, and then it transfers and inserts it into viral particles. Viruses collected from these packaging cells are then applied to the cells to be altered, so the cells that you actually wish to study. When you apply the supernatant collected from your packaging cell to your target cell, in the case of the lentivirus, you will get integration of your target gene into the host genome and therefore continue to get expression of that gene stably.